Lisa will be back with Politics Monday in just a moment. But first, election officials across the country are considering how to adjust to the pandemic. Louisiana, Georgia, and Ohio have now postponed their primary contests, and candidates have scrapped public rallies altogether. Stephanie Tsai has this report from Arizona, where some 80% of voters were expected to mail in their ballots ahead of tomorrow's primary contest, and the race is still on.
Seemingly undeterred by the threat of coronavirus, the farmers market in downtown Phoenix was buzzing this weekend. New rules enacted since the outbreak prevented J.D. Duke from offering up samples of his organic cookies, but he was handing out political opinions for free.
I do feel that we need a change in our leadership in our country.
Duke is still undecided, but over at the Community Food Cooperative, Kenny Bisaw was wearing his support for Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders.
The same people that stayed home when they ran Hillary against Trump are going to stay home when they run Joe Biden against Trump. And it's out of a frustration, and it's out of a lack of empathy on their part.
How has Trump been for the Latino community?
Horrible.
Alexis Delgado Garcia is another vote for Sanders, but the first-time voter plans on backing whoever the eventual nominee is.
What?
Some of his family members have never gained legal status, even though they've lived in Arizona for decades. Alexis is one of a growing number of voting-age Latinos that want to swing Arizona blue.
It's about people over profit and being able to understand that people matter, our values matter, our emotions matter, everything about us matters. I'm going to represent my family. I'm going to represent my mom and my dad.
Joe Garcia is both director of public policy at Chicanos Por La Causa and a longtime Arizona political journalist.
It's young Latinos, and that's going to be the key. Because when they were growing up, perhaps one or both of their parents might not have been able to vote because they weren't here with documentation. So they're ineligible. But about 95% of young Latinos were born here or naturalized, and they're able to vote.
Whether the younger voters turn out is the question. 64-year-old Dora Vasquez is a third-generation Mexican-American. She was determined to hold her debate watch party Sunday evening.
It does concern me, but I don't want to live in fear.
Even as she worried that coronavirus concerns might impact the elections.
I'm very concerned about the ability to people to get out and meet with voters.
Maricopa County has closed some 80 polling sites and is enacting emergency protocols that allow voters to cast their ballot at any of more than 150 voting centers. State Democratic Party officials say the early voting tradition in Arizona might minimize the impact of the outbreak. Vasquez voted early for Senator Elizabeth Warren before she dropped out.
I wanted Warren to be our president because she's a woman. I have 4 to 5 elections left in my lifetime. It was very disappointing. It seemed to me that the good old boy system was in play again.
Besides the growing Hispanic population, the other major factor affecting Arizona politics is the number of out-of-state residents moving here. The Phoenix metro area is the fastest growing in America, and a lot of those so-called transplants bring their politics with them.
East of Phoenix lie the affluent Scottsdale suburbs, which includes zip code 85255, one of the top sources of Trump campaign donations in 2016. Lane Mankel and Mike Watt moved here from Connecticut.
Well, I'll tell you, when I told my great friends that I was moving out here, my best friend, now unfortunately gone, he said, Mike, you cannot move to Arizona. I said, why? I said, because it's too Republican. You know, you're going to perish.
They didn't perish, and in fact found a group of like-minded folks in the area who meet every Sunday to talk politics.
We have one or two nice Republican people, but the rest are Democrats, so that's very nourishing for us.
Several members were absent this week due to coronavirus concerns, and extra precautions were taken. But the conversations were no less vibrant.
Arizona is a pivotal state.
The talk centered around which candidate was best equipped to beat President Trump.
How many of you are supporting Vice President Joe Biden in this? If Bernie Sanders ends up the Democratic nominee, how many of you will still come out and vote for Sanders?
Oh, you have to. You have to, because then it's Trump.
The 2018 midterm victories for Democrats made it clear the state is in flux. Garcia describes the dynamics using a quintessential Arizona analogy. of haboobs, intense dust storms typical here in the summers.
So you have the two haboobs, the homegrown Latino voters who are coming up for the first time, and then, of course, the newcomers who are moving into Arizona with their own politics. So the two haboobs hitting, we'll see when the dust settles where it all is.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Stephanie Tsai in Phoenix.